Hi everyone. In this video, we're going to be looking at a 3-month study plan, a 90-day study plan for the GRE that commences sometime by the end of July 2022 or early August 2022, so that you'll be able to write your GRE by the end of October of this year. This entire study plan is focused on students who are doing their engineering, typically a 4-year program, in the 6th semester of their engineering. In a normal year, a pre-pandemic year, 6-semester examinations typically used to take place by the end of May, and by mid-June, you would have your examinations over. This year, it's a slightly different scenario. The examinations are likely to get over by mid-July for most of us. Sometimes it could even stretch to the 3rd week of July. So keeping that in mind, we've drawn a study plan which will last for 90 days and should help you get a good score in the GRE. Right? Basically, I've kept this entire study plan starting from sometime around the 3rd week of July. There are 2 things that you need to do. From the time your 6th semester examination gets over, which is let's say by the 20th of July to the 31st of July, the first act that you need to do is basically take a diagnostic test. As I mentioned in an earlier video, the diagnostic test serves 2 purposes. The first one that it does, it gives you a good idea about the lay of the land. It tells you what are the different sections in the GRE, what are the different types of questions in the GRE. You get a first-hand experience about what is tested in the GRE. We all know there is math, we all know there is verbal. Within verbal, what is there? At some level, we know there is vocabulary. But how is vocabulary tested in the GRE? What do we mean by a text sentence equivalence question? What do we mean by a text completion question? Someone were to ask, hey, what are these? At some level, I'll say, these are fill-in-the-blanks question. But then if they're fill-in-the-blanks question, why is there a different type of question called sentence equivalence? And why is there a different kind of question called text completion? So what is expected? What are the nuance between these 2 types of questions? And how do you plug in the vocabulary, the word list that you're probably going to be using to learn these words into solving these types of questions? The same goes when it comes to the math section. GRE math, yes, there is a problem solving type of question. You have a question followed by 5 answer options. But there are other types of questions which are called the quantitative comparison questions. Select one or more answer type. So you would have read about this, you would have heard about it, but taking a diagnostic test tells you how these questions are framed. We know reading comprehension typically has a passage. How many passages are there in the GRE? What is the length of the passage? How many questions to a passage? What do we mean by highlight on in the passage, a particular section of the passage? All of these things, you will get a first-hand experience if you take a diagnostic test. This is the first thing that you get to know. You know the different types of questions and everything. The second thing that it also does is it helps you identify your strengths and weakness, right? Strength and weakness, think of it in 3 layers. The first one, at the broadest level, at section level, I can say, hey, I'm stronger in math than in verbal or vice versa. That's a section level one. The second one is basically saying that, hey, I'm stronger in a particular concept than in another. It could possibly more easily explain in a quantitative reasoning concept, right? I'm strong in geometry, but not in algebra, or vice versa, right? I'm strong in inequalities, but not in rates kind of a question. So these are concept related. So it's a layer two. The third layer, it also helps you identify things like, you would say, hey, I'm able to solve all questions. I didn't have a problem with any of these concepts at all. If the question is given to me as a problem solving question, question followed by 5 answer options, I got every single one of them right in the diagnostic test. But they twisted the question and made it as a quantitative comparison question. Out of the 5 questions that were there in the test, I got 3 of them incorrect. So that's a format problem for you, right? So it could be identifying strengths and weaknesses at the broader level, saying that I'm generically stronger in math than in verbal or vice versa. Or you could say that I'm stronger in a specific concept area than in another. I need to basically do more work in the other one. Or the third is, hey, I'm reasonably good at the concept overall, but the question format familiarity is what basically jinxed me when it came to the score that I got. So these are the 3 levels of identifying strengths and weaknesses. All of us will identify on all 3 layers. It's not just going to be in 1 layer. You'll say, I'm definitely better in math. I need to work a lot more in verbal. And within that, you'll say that, hey, I'm good in understanding the meanings of the word, but when it comes to plugging it as a sentence equivalence, I seem to be struggling. That could be a format kind of a thing. Or you'll say, I do the words better, but I have problem when it comes to reading and making sense of the comprehension. So I need to work on reading a lot more. So it could be on all 3 layers, you will have identified your strengths and weaknesses. Make a note of it, right? This diagnostic test, you typically will have to take at least 1 quant and 1 verbal section. Where do you take it? There's a free diagnostic test available at Wizako's portal, learning portal. Use this URL, wzko.pro/diagnostic. It's a free diagnostic test for 1 hour and 5 minutes, 35 minutes of quant with 20 questions and 30 minutes of verbal with 20 questions, exactly mimicking the pattern of the questions that appear in the GRE. Right. So 1 hour, 5 minutes is what it takes to take the test. You'd probably take another 1 hour to see, note down how many mistakes, corrects that you made and all of that. And spend a couple of hours in building a strategy saying that these are the places that I need to work on. These are the types of questions. These are the concept areas that I'm weak on, and this is where I need help, right? So this is what a diagnostic test does to you. Take this diagnostic test immediately after your even semester examination gets over. Let's say your examinations get over on the 20th of July. On the 21st of July, you should have taken this test. By the end of 22nd of July, 2 days from the time your entire even semester examination gets over, you need to have an Excel sheet where you say that conceptually, these are the things I have to work on. This is relatively stronger, this is relatively weaker. I have to work on this particular question format. You need to have a clarity on that. Get this done by the within 2 days from the time your even semester examination gets over. And you also need to do one more thing between that time and the end of July. Make sense of, can you do preparation for GRE on your own? Self-study for GRE is a possibility, or you need help for GRE. Be objective about it. There's no machoness in this saying that I prepared for the GRE all by myself. You're trying to get a good score in GRE, and therefore that's going to help you get a good admit and a scholarship. When should you say that I can just go ahead with self-study? Let's say there are 20 questions in the quantitative reasoning and there are 20 questions in the verbal reasoning diagnostic test. If you get 16 or more questions right in both the sections, I think you're generically good in both these things. You are a person who is ideally, either because of your past experiences or you're made that way, you're wired that way, that you're going to be scoring well in the GRE. At that point in time, all that you need to do is basically use the next 1 month, right? Use the entire August to do self-study. You probably need the following books to essentially ramp up your preparation. Pick up the official guide for the GRE, which is a full book. Also get the quant and the verbal separate books, right? Get all of these books. And I would recommend pick any of those books which give you thousands of questions. There's a Manhattan 5-pound book. There's a Princeton book. Manhattan is a good book to buy. Pick that book and finish off your self-study and be done with it. Because you scored 16 plus in both the sections, you probably do not need any help and you could manage the GRE all by yourself. By first week of September, if you fall under this category, someone who scored 16 plus questions right in both the sections, you should be able to write the GRE by the first week of September, and there's a very high likelihood that you would score upward of 330 in the GRE, right? Let's come to the next set of people. If you've scored somewhere around the 10 or 12, right, you're good to start with, but the 10 or 12 in both the sections, right, or in any one of the sections, if you scored only 10 or 12, there's no point trying to do self-study, right? You want to, you have college, you're in your final semester, you're going to be having your placement pressures, you have to do your final year project. There's so many things happening there, and you don't want to have your time and energy invested in figuring out how to do anything for GRE. You would rather invest the time and effort in preparing for the GRE where someone has made it available to you on a platter. They know the structure of what you want, they provided you what is actually tested in the GRE, there is someone to teach you. Figure out what actually works for you, right? Could possibly go for offline classes if offline classes are available to you. Could go for a private tutor if you have access to a private tutor. Or I would recommend online courses for the simple reason many of us may not have access to good teachers at reasonable distance from the place where we stay if you are looking at a physical classroom program. Online courses typically are run by teachers who are basically experts who have done this for a lot of time. So either pick a live online class if you want the discipline and the ability to get doubts clarified then and there, or go for a pre-recorded course so that you can pace the entire preparation by yourself. But certainly, if you've got 10, 12 or lesser marks scored in any one of these sections, self-study is definitely not for you, right? Identify which is the course that you're going to be taking. Take demo classes, take trial classes, speak to tutors, speak to companies, figure out, hey, this is what I'm going to be doing. Get this done before the end of July. Sign up for it that by early August, you should be ready to roll and start preparing, right? So step one, take a diagnostic test, identify the company that you're going to be preparing, which is step two, which is a part of step one, step two, and get started with your preparation in early August. Get the fundamentals in place. Run through the word list that is given to you. There's a high frequency word list that you need to be preparing. Get those meanings in place. Get those variations of those, right? It's an adjective that you've got. Find out what's a noun form. Where is a noun form used? And if it's reading comprehension, run through passages of all kinds. Social sciences passages, physical sciences passages, astronomy passages. You need to read passages of all kinds. Get familiar with it. If it's math, get all of those quant areas, which is like geometry, algebra, arithmetic in place. In this preparation, in this phase, which is going to be during the most of August, focus not just on the how, but also on the why, what, when, because GRE places an emphasis on not just saying, hey, factorize x square plus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. They essentially will test you in such a way that you have figured out what that equation stands for. What's a quadratic equation when you plot it on a graph paper? What are the roots of the quadratic equation on that particular curve that we are talking about? Get clarity on this. That's what I mean by this. And when you're talking about, again, words, let's come to verbal. It's not just knowing the meaning of the word, which is one part, but you add preposition. Adding an at or adding an on or adding a for could make a difference to the meaning of the word, and therefore one would be a proper one in the sentence equivalence, the other may not be. So get clarity on how prepositions and other things change the meaning of the word. And two words might probably mean the same thing, but they might be used in different contexts. So know the context in which to use them. So these nuances you need to learn as you're doing the fundamentals. As you do the fundamentals, you'll definitely be doing practice. You're not going to be learning how to factorize a quadratic equation without solving questions in quadratic equation. At the initial phase, these quadratic equation questions that you'll be solving would be more of problem solving questions. Third phase of your preparation should basically bring in representative questions. These are the GRE type questions, right? You've done quadratic equations, you've done problem solving, you've got familiarity with it. At the second part of your preparation span, right, which is probably sometime which is going to be end August and the whole of September, you'll start plugging in the GRE type questions within the same thing. You'll solve quantitative comparison question and select one or more questions in quadratic equation. You will solve reading comprehension initially as reading a passage, getting the answers. Subsequently, you'll also look at reading comprehension passages where you're going to highlight a portion of it. You're going to be just doing word list in the first part of August. Second part of August, you'll be plugging in this word list into sentence equivalence practice and into text completion practice. So this would start from, let's say, the third or fourth, probably the fourth week of August and span through the entire September, right? So we started our preparation in August, got the basics in place, did the word list quickly in one round, the high frequency word, and probably the second set of word list also in place. From the end of August to the whole of September, we're going to use all of these concepts, we're going to strengthen the concepts and also plug them in simultaneously into the GRE-ish kind of things. The fourth one, which is the most important thing, you've done all of these things and you should be done with all of these things by end of September. At least one round of completing all this concepts and question type practice should be done by September end. Get started with your mock test by early October. Reserve the whole of October as a feedback month. Take one mock test, identify your strengths, weaknesses. Identifying your strengths, weaknesses again would essentially mean, hey, I took more time in this question and I got it wrong. So I need to understand the concept. See whether you can plug in the concept that the next time you see a question of this kind, you'll be able to solve it in probably a minute and a half. Conversely, you'll come back and saying that this is a concept which I'm struggling. If I get this question in the GRE, I'll mark something and move on. I'm not going to be investing time initially. If I have time for it, I'll come back to this question. There could be another question where you know the concept, but however much you try, you know that you are taking 2.5 minutes to solve this question. You'll say, I'll keep this question for review in GRE if it comes. I'll quickly run through it and come back and solve it later. I'm not going to be doing it in the first round. So getting this kind of a concept and also understanding, these are the concept areas, I still need improvement. This is where I lost time and I need to basically buck up in that particular area. Getting all of these inputs out from the test that you're taking. Take test one, see that these are the four things that I need to work on. Work on those things and then take the next test. See if you have seen improvement in that. And then identify another two or three things that you need to improve on. Use every test as a feedback loop, right? Should be taking a minimum of 6 tests. Keep the 2 official tests which are available at the GRE.com, at ETS.org, their official website, to be the last 2 tests that you'll be taking before you actually hit the examination. Because the score that you get there is going to be the closest representative of what you're likely to get in the GRE. Do this step 4, should be able to take your GRE by end of October. Here is the typical timeline. Start by 20th of July, do a diagnostic test, make a note of your strengths, weaknesses and chart, this is how I want to go about it. Based on your diagnostic test, figure out whether it's self-study, in that case, collect the books. If it is something where if you've got 10 or 12 or lesser in any one section, don't do self-study, it's not worth it at all. You probably would like get help from any good tutor or a company which is into this training that you're able to score well in the GRE, right? Get the actual preparation started in August, do the fundamentals by third week of August, which is essentially saying that I've got most of these concepts in place once, I've solved the questions that are required to factorize a quadratic equation, to take LCM, HCF, to know the word list, and I'm going to plug that in into practice, which are GRE type questions. Which could be a sentence equivalence question, could be a quantitative comparison question, by end of August to the whole of September. Practices. You'll still be learning concepts. You'll be learning tougher concepts. You'll be plugging it in and you'll get familiarity with that. Keep the entire October for the feedback loop. Take a mock, get the feedback. If there are some more questions that you need to solve in inequalities, go and do it. There are 10 more sentence equivalence questions that you need to do so that you're familiar with this entire idea, do it. Use this as a feedback loop. It's not as if you stop learning at this point. Take the GRE by end October. It'll give you adequate time to apply early enough. If you've taken the GRE by end October, getting your statement of purpose in place, getting the recommendation letters from your professors, getting the transcripts in place, and doing all of that, you should be able to apply by, let's say, end of November. You should be able to push out at least 4 or 5 of this college's applications. That you would have your results by late January, early February, that when you're in your final semester, you know where you stand. Have you got scholarships? Have you got admission? Which is the place that you want to go to? All of this clarity will be there. And taking this, going about the study plan, also gives you a shot at a plan B. What if your end October GRE, you're looking at a 320 plus GRE score? It ended up being a 299. Prepare for one more month. Identify what went wrong. I note those rough edges. That you're able to take the GRE by end November, that still you'll be able to catch the entire application window by mid-December or 20th of December, that you'll still be getting your results by mid-February of next year. So it's a 90-day study plan. As your 6th semester examination gets over, right, when you heave a sigh of relief saying, hey, ek aur semester ho gaya, this is the time to basically get cracking on the GRE so that you're able to get into a college of your choice with scholarship, with a good GRE score in August 2023. Best wishes. If you would like to get more help from us, follow us on these platforms. On Twitter and Instagram, we are at Wizako GRE. YouTube, we are on Wizako GRE. Most of these places, our handle is Wizako GRE, with the exception of Facebook, where it is Wizako Prep GRE. And you can reach out to our counselors and tutors on WhatsApp at 93800 48484.